Our chief guest for the evening, Dr. Ali Khwaja, is a Montessorian, an engineering graduate of IIT, MIE, MIIM, with a PhD in behavioral sciences. He has always carved out his own path and been a freelancer, ensuring that his work is a constant source of joy each and every day.
He is invited regularly to conduct workshops and lectures for defense, central government, prestigious national institutions, schools and colleges. But he prefers to be informal, learning while he teaches and being honest and congruent in whatever he says or does.
He is the founder and head of Banjara Academy, a unique institution committed to the improvement of quality of life. He nurtures and motivates over 200 volunteers to give free service in 10 hospitals and the Academy's own counseling centers. He conducts popular and practical courses in counseling skills and life skills. It is therefore quite amazing that he still finds time for causes as wide as adoption, disability welfare, and true education.
Notwithstanding all this, he loves all human beings alike, is willing to listen, and his prime focus is on empowering individuals to help themselves.
Thank you, sir, for finding time in your busy schedule to grace this occasion. May I now request our chief guest to kindly address the audience and share his wisdom with us.
You just heard the invocation, Guru Ma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara. Whatever we are today is because of so many of our gurus, some of whom we acknowledge, some of whom we are not even aware of. If you just heard my introduction and if you felt, oh, this man has done something worthwhile in his life, I think the credit does not go to me, it goes to my gurus who made me what I am. And in this 21st century, when I see that education has moved from our traditional gurukuls to becoming literally a business, where you have corporate houses and you have business people and all these people who are competing with each other to have schools which are more and more fancy and which look more like five-star hotels than like schools. I was being told lately about a school which is being set up in another city of India where they were talking about having an air-conditioned football field. Air-conditioned football field. I thought the whole idea of playing football is to sweat it out in the dust and grime and tumble and, you know, feel the joy of being a sports person. But imagine you are going to play football in an air-conditioned field. In that sort of a trend which has started now, I get extremely happy when I come to a place like this where the Guru Parampara of the olden ages is being revived and is being upheld. Yes, I think your school, Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji, all your teachers, principal, committee members, they all deserve an applause because they are here not with the general you know, intention with which a lot of schools are being started, but with the whole idea that you know, good education should be given. Today, since I am addressing the parents, I've already had one very nice interaction with the teachers and I was very impressed with them and their commitment and their dedication. So much so that when I asked them why are they teachers, hardly anybody mentioned money, if you remember. So I told ma'am that you don't have to pay salaries to your teachers because nobody said we are here for money. But today, since I am here addressing you parents, I wanted you to make you aware, not as a so-called expert or something of that sort, because But as a person whose one qualification is normally missed out when my introduction is given, and that is that I am the proud father of two children who are already adults who have grown up. Neither of them has landed in jail or in a mental asylum or in has become a drug addict or anything. Incidentally, neither of them went to Harvard or MIT or IIM or IIT, but they are happy young people. They are doing exactly what they feel like doing. They uphold certain basic values, and that is what makes me proud of my children. Having gone through this experience, I also wanted to share something very important with you, that both my children have become very boring people because they have become adults. When they were children, they were such wonderful people to have in the house. Life was so enjoyable. But unfortunately, we think of it only when it is too late. Today you have your children with you. They may be very obedient children, I hope they are not. They may be naughty children, congratulations if they are. They may have a lot of ups and downs and swings. Every now and then you must be wondering, what does this child want? Why does he or she behave like this? It is because the child wants to explore the world and learn something new. I remember one mother was very exasperated with her daughter, and she was saying, I don't know why you came into my life and why you are making my life so miserable. And the girl looked at her mother and said, Ma, I think I am your karma. Yes, I think that is what children are. Children can make our life wonderful, provided we stop taking our role very seriously. I think the best parent is a parent who forgets that he or she is a parent. If we take our role too seriously, if I say I want my child to stand first in class, I want my child to be an achiever, I want my child to be an engineer or whatever it is, we are making life miserable for the child. Go back and have a look at the Guru Shishya Parampara which existed for thousands of years before the British came to India. No child was taught the three R's. No child was taught or given coaching for IIT entrance exam from sixth standard or something of that sort. The Guru used to ensure that the child becomes a good human being. And then when the child grows up, the child used to be mature enough, capable enough to take his or her decisions and then go and learn vocational skills which would make the child capable of earning money or, you know, being a productive member of society. Somewhere we have forgotten that we have to start with giving the basic inputs to a child, the values. For example, today, these children of yours, the 21st century children as I call them, have no role models. I belong to that generation where in our school we used to have a lovely photograph of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the very handsome Prime Minister of India with his Gandhi cap, his white sherwani and a red rose. And he was not Prime Minister Nehru to us, he was Chacha Nehru. His birthday was Children's Day. That's how we used to look up at our heroes. Today, before you tell your child about some minister or commissioner or somebody, better check the day's newspaper whether he has been arrested and put in jail himself or something of that sort. In this world that our children are growing up in, the one thing that the child should have, let the child face any negativity outside. Let the child come to know about terrorism, corruption and this and that and everything, as long as the child knows, understands and is reassured that the home is a cocoon. The home is an oasis where daddy may not be a minister, mummy may not be a commissioner, but they are people who uphold values. They are people who keep up to their word. A simple thing like telling, promising your child, okay, today if you do well in this program of the school. Tomorrow I will take you out and we will have a nice picnic or shopping or something. And then tomorrow morning you get up and say, no, 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 today I have some very urgent work and I have to go, finished. These are the small things which we learn, need to learn from our gurus and in turn become gurus to our children. The mother and father cannot abdicate their role as gurus. They are the most important gurus and they are there 24/7 with children. We need to just look into some very basic things. In fact, I would like to leave you with just 3 points which if you carry home with you and if you practice, I think you can make the life of your child wonderful. The first one is communication. Learn how to communicate with your child. And you know how communication is spelled? I don't know if there's an English teacher here. According to my English teacher, communication is spelled L-I-S-T-E-N. Listen to your child. Otherwise, there's a proverb which says, we spend the first 2 years of a child's life teaching him how to talk and spend the next 16 years of his life telling him to shut up. We want to do all the talking. Please don't do that. Learn to listen to your child. Even if your child is a tiny tot, he may not have something earth-shaking to tell you, but learn to listen to his emotions. That's what a child needs. Let the whole world go in one direction. Let the child come back with that warm, reassuring feeling that my amma and my appa listen to me. They may not agree with me, but they listen to me. Point number one. Point number two, a lot of people ask me, since we are basically counselors and we do a lot of counseling and all that, people ask about discipline matters. I tell them one very basic and important thing: consistency in discipline. Make any rule that you want, as long as you can justify it and you stick to that rule. Don't keep changing rules. That is what makes a child very upset. And the worst thing that you can do is what we call as, you know, treating parenting as a popularity contest. Doing your parenting to impress others. My mother-in-law should not get an impression that I am a bad mother, so when my mother-in-law is here, I will behave differently with my child. When I go to the mall, people are watching when my child is throwing a tantrum, so let me buy and give it off to him. You're doing the wrong thing. Be consistent in whatever you feel. Believe in it. When you believe in whatever discipline you are doing, the child agrees with you. If you tell lies, if you bluff, if the child says, I want to buy this toy, and you say, we don't have the money for it, it is costing 200 rupees, we don't have the money. And then you go and buy something which is 2000 rupees worth, you think the child doesn't know? That is what I said, when you impose, when you say, I don't want to buy it, you say, I have the money. I have 10 times the money, but I don't think this is worth buying. That's my opinion. I am your father, I am your mother. I want to tell you this, 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 this. Then let the child throw any number of tantrums. The third and perhaps the most important of the 3 points that I wanted to share with you is to be a good role model. That's what I said, today's children have no role models. Let the parents be a role model. Let the parents tell the truth to the child. 10 times we tell the child that telling lies is a sin. And halfway through our telling the child, we pick up the mobile phone and we start talking. Yes, sir. Yes, definitely. I will see that your material is dispatched. I'm in the factory right now. I will ensure that the material is dispatched. Then only I'll go home, sir. Yeah. Child looks at appa. He's telling a lie. Then he looks at amma. Amma used to give so many lectures about telling lies. No, now she'll get very angry with appa. She says, "Arey, good you told him off. Otherwise, if you had said you are at home, he would have landed up here." This is what it is. Very simple. But be very careful, because there's a proverb that says children are very poor at listening to their parents, but they are very good at mimicking them. They pick up cues like this. They are always observing you. If you don't believe me, today evening go home, give a half an hour lecture to your child and he doesn't listen to a single word. After that you say, okay, you go and play. And both mother and father go to one corner and start talking. Immediately his antenna goes up. He starts coming closer and closer. What is going on over here? So you have on the one side a very important role, on the other side you also have to understand that a child is like a sapling. The seed has, you know, sprouted, the child is now growing up. You cannot dictate whether this plant should give you mangoes or apples. It will give what it wants. You cannot dictate that your child wants to be an engineer. If he wants to be a fashion model, he'll turn out to be a very happy fashion model. It is you who will be sitting and breaking your head against the thing. The same way as we nurture a plant and allow the plant to grow up and be what it is, whether the plant is giving, and every plant is unique, the same way every child is unique. One child will give shade, one child will give fruits, one child will give flowers, one child will grow very fast, one child will grow very slow. Allow the child to grow at his or her own pace. Respect the individuality of the child. Despite all your efforts, if at any time you feel that there is anything which is going beyond your control and you are not able to deal with your child, we offer a free counseling service to anyone and everyone, not just with regard to children. Any emotional issue, interpersonal issue, parenting, anything of that sort, you are absolutely free to get in touch with us. You can log on to our website, which is banjaraacademy.org, not .com. So anytime you log in, there's a lot of material all in the free domain. You can download anything that you want, which helps you to understand the quality of life and relationships, family, parenting, children, all those things. And if you have any inquiry, you can write to us or you can come over. The address and telephone number, everything is given over there. It's a free service. It is confidential. It is one-to-one. If we deal with your child or anything of that sort, we are not going to call up ma'am tomorrow and say, you know, your child had come or something of that sort. We maintain that confidentiality. And we are there to help you, support you in this wonderful journey of being a parent and enjoying your parenting. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for that invigorating and inspiring address.